Bella's Dial Dehydrator. I've used it several times. I like it quite a bit. Basically, open that up. Got six trays. They slide in. Got six of them. We're gonna do some elk steaks, elk roast. We're gonna turn that into some whole muscle jerky. That elk, we're gonna do this Eastman Outdoors Jerky Cure and Seasoning. It's for specifically for wild game. 5 pounds of meat. I'll show you what's next. Go over a little bit of what I'm doing to prepare. This is the elk, still partially frozen. Slicing it up into about 1/4 inch sticks. Throw it over here in the bucket, and that'll be where I marinate it. This one, so try and trim off the fat because it kind of holds your jerky together. Really lean meat for jerky. Alright guys, I'm kind of just one-handed holding the camera, but this is 1 ounce of curing salt. Yeah, this stuff's going to have to rotate around. I think I'll leave it on, I'll massage it all in, but it's not so easy to do on camera. And then we got 1 ounce of that original jerky seasoning. And then this is to taste. This is not part of their setup, but some Worcestershire sauce. And I'm gonna bear with me. And again, this meat is still a little bit frozen, so it's not gonna be the best, but I'm just massaging it into this meat best that I can, moving around. All the meat needs to have that seasoning, or that curing salt on it, just in case we need to hydrate. Doesn't get
full penetration, doesn't pull all that moisture out. It'll be at least cooked, so it's safe to eat. So, yeah, I'm gonna massage it into all these pieces, all these sticks. This is 5 pounds of elk. Move it over into this tray so it sits a little bit flatter, get some more of that moisture on there. I'm gonna go ahead and put this in the fridge. It'll sit for, well, probably 2 hours before I go to bed, and then I'll rotate it again, and then it'll sit overnight. And I get the morning, I'll rotate it another time. All right, guys, this is the jerky update 24 hours later after marinating. I'm gonna get a wrap filled. So, several pieces. I don't want any pieces to touch. I want to be full. I'll bring you back and show you here once I get this one full. This tray is full. Take a paper towel and I'm just going to pat it dry. I want as much moisture off of it now as possible. I don't want to pull that seasoning out or pull it off, but I want it to be dry. And don't want any to touch. Sometimes you get little pieces like that that are touching. I'll try to pull them up, try to get everything as flat as possible, make everything as uniform as possible. Take the tray, set it on in. Guys, this is just a little tip that I do. Don't have to, it's not required by any means, but I always take my trays out and rotate top to bottom. The little thing you can do is turn it around. That heating element is way very far back. That heating element, it is going to heat up some of it more. Yes, there's a fan in there and it blows and circulates. You can hear it running, but it's not going to be perfect. So just a little tip that I've done. Again, I'm not perfect. Sometimes I forget some. Sometimes I mess up some, but do this before I go to bed. taste test of my jerky. Pretty good. 2020 elk season, jerky is ready.